A large, solitary landmass seems set adrift in the Indian Ocean off the coast of Mozambique. This isolation has fostered a unique collection of plants and wildlife, more than three quarters of which exist nowhere else on Earth.
They call Madagascar the land that time forgot. This island nation of ours is one of the richest storehouses of the planet's biodiversity.
The fourth largest island in the world, Madagascar is a land of lush tropical rainforests, believed to contain almost half of the world's plant species. The Malagasy people migrated here from southern Asia only 1,500 years ago. But as their population grows and a poor economy breeds a culture of subsistence slash and burn farming, Madagascar's breathtaking rainforests are being transformed into barren wastelands.
Madagascar's population is increasing. And that rate of growth is outpacing the resources that is available. Farmers have to continuously cut the forest to feed their people. And this is causing havoc to the environment. We are losing biological diversity.
Dr. Nat Kwanza is an expert on the treasures of Madagascar's forests. Born in Ghana, educated in London as an ethnobotanist, he is desperately concerned about the loss of medicinal plants and the decline of a cultural tradition that uses natural substances for curative purposes.
People are part of biodiversity. People and plants have a relationship. People using plants for medicine is their topmost priority in terms of humans' relationship with plants.
In 1994, Nat Kwanza founded a clinic in the village of Ambo de Sequana, which combined traditional and modern medicine. A native healer worked alongside doctors trained in Western medicine. Thousands of villagers flocked to the clinic. Some would walk hundreds of miles along muddy trails, carrying patients on makeshift stretchers.
About a third of the time, traditional medicine works just fine. And ironically, modern pharmaceuticals work 20, 30, 40% of the time as well. Neither of those systems is in by itself an integrated whole system. And that's putting them together with conservation and local people.
The idea of a link between traditional medicine and forest preservation may be new to some, but Nat Kwanza is convinced it's an idea whose time is here.
If that relationship, that link, is not reinforced, it becomes difficult for people to see the importance of saving the biodiversity.
Kwanza's theories are slowly being embraced by the Malagasy government. Acknowledging biodiversity is one of the island's greatest treasures. It has drafted the National Environmental Action Plan.
Frankly, it is impossible to think of conservation of the environment without making the people that live in those territories benefit from it. Conservation has to go hand in hand with sustainable development.
After all, the world is round. What happens in Madagascar affects the other inhabitants of this planet Earth and the other part of the world.
Dr. Kwanza's ideas are beginning to take hold in some remote areas. One by one, indigenous people are learning the benefits of preservation.
Working with the community needs building up trust. Once that trust is built, it becomes easy to discuss all sorts of things. We want to meet them on the health front, because people carrying patients 100 kilometers, that is difficult. So setting up the clinic in their area, combining it with modern medication, has made that trust be put on a strong footing.
Back at the clinic, the forest is already benefiting from the trust and respect Nat Kwanza has achieved.
The community's priority had to be our priority. After all, what are we there for? We said we are there to help them learn how to help themselves.
In 1998, the clinic ran out of money to pay the doctors. Villagers who came to depend on the clinic are attempting to raise funds themselves to keep it open. Nat Kwanza contributes what money he can from personal funds.
The presence of the two medical traditions working together make people realize there is no conflict. After all, both sides want to help save lives.
For outstanding environmental achievement in island nations, the year 2000 Goldman Environmental Prize is awarded to Nat Kwanza of Antananarivo, Madagascar.